じゃあ飛んでる
回転の気分を出したい。
In this video, we are going to talk about the graduation thesis written by Yuzuru Hanyu, which is recently published by Waseda University. Just a quick intro. Waseda University is the top private research university in Japan. Their notable alumni include seven prime ministers of Japan, some top country leaders of China, co-founders and corporate leaders of Japan brands like Sony and Nintendo, and the world-renowned novelist, Haruki Murakami. In no time, this thesis has attracted tens of thousands of downloads from all over the world, and a lot of heated debates on Twitter and Reddit. So what is the thesis really about?
CGSK においてそのモーションキャプチャー技術っていうのはどれだけ使えるかっていうのと、あとどういうふうな展望があるかっていうのを、まあ、まとめた論文です、基本的には。
In the opening of the thesis, Hanyu introduced a wireless inertial sensor type motion capture systems developed by the Dutch company named Exons,which has enabled the records of human body movement for real-life application in ergonomics, sports science, and rehabilitation. Let's take a look.
3D motion tracking is very popular. It's used in video games, you've seen it in movies, it's even used for research. But unless you have a giant studio with a lot of different devices everywhere, it can be difficult. But a company called Exons makes it a lot easier. They have a suit,
which is a fully wireless, 17 trackers that go to a single USB hub. It is inertial based motion capture, so you don't need optical, you don't need a bunch of cameras for a stage. It's your body moving sensors, then comes into our software MVN Animate, where we calculate it on a humanoid structure and give data for games and films.
As time goes by, these sensors have evolved and become even smaller and more accurate. Perhaps inspired by the adaptation of AI judging in gymnastics,which has a similar subjective judging system like figure skating. Hanyu wanted to see how AI can help in figure skating judging too. Then he covers around the fairness of figure skating scoring and judging systems. From his tone, he believes all judges and the skating union want fair judging. So I hope people watching this don't take it personally. It's a pure technical discussion by a skating enthusiast. To summarize the points, firstly,It has become extremely difficult for judges to accurately judge the jumps with human eyes because the technical level of figure skating jumps has improved tremendously in recent years. In addition, there are a lot of ambiguities in the evaluation criteria. And yes, that's true. I was laughing when I was reading the ISU judging guides. For instance, very good height, good body position, good takeoff, etc. Coming from an engineering background, there is always this question in my head.
Define the word good.
Is 50 centimeters height good? How about 60 centimeters? At what speed is considered good speed? 25? 27? There is no clarification on these, and these ambiguities are left at the sole discretion of the referee on that competition. Then, he covers around the fatigue factor. Take the world championship, for example. There are around 30 skaters in each competition. For each skater,They need to perform 7 elements in the short program and 12 in the free. For each technical element, there are around 6 positive bullets and 20 negative bullets for the grade of execution judging ranging from plus 5 to minus 5. Then, there are 5 program components ranging from 0 to 10 to be scored. So, each judge has to make at least 300 decisions over 200 considerations in the short programs, and 500 decisions over 300 considerable variables in the free.Furthermore, the rules of the judging criteria are revised every year. The judges must always remember the latest standards and evaluate all the elements within 1 to 2 seconds. Is there time to make a calm decision? Can you imagine how taxing this task is? And they are not paid. It's on volunteer basis. Judging from all the factors above, do you think they will follow the guidelines strictly? I can't imagine that.And there were athletes who have voiced out about the unfair judging in multiple interviews.
Ich habe hier gerade, ich war wirklich enttäuscht und auch ein bisschen sauer. Aua, jetzt tut mir auch kleine meine Beine weh, weil ich mir hier drauf schlage. Nee, also Aber, ja, ist um Gottes Willen, die Goldmedaille ist auch verdient. Oh. Also man soll ihr das auch nicht absprechen.
Ist klar.
Aber ja. Ich verstehe es nicht.
Komm mal runter. Und Katharina, durchatmen.
Nee, ich, nee.
Tschüss.
With these in mind, He went on to do the experiment to see if the wireless inertial sensor type motion capture systems can be used to record the detailed movements of all the figure skating jumps. If yes, then it will be possible to further define the correct techniques for each skating jump using the real figure skater's body, and that can be used for training and judging in the future. This will allow figure skating to better develop as a fair and objective sport. Hanyu used three kinds of jumps to conduct the experiments. The flip, the loop, and the axel jump. The reason for selecting these three jumps is because they have completely different mechanisms for takeoff, and he expected to see huge differences in the data collected. Hanyu spent a good chunk of his thesis explaining the physics behind these three jumps. I will try to summarize it here. The loop is a jump that takes off using the momentum of rotation and centrifugal force while skating with the edge of the blades on a curve. Whereby the flip is a jump that takes off using the toe pick of the right foot to stab on the ice, utilizing the inertia of motion to generate rotational velocity for the jump.
Confused yet?
Here is a quick analogy for the not-so-technical figure skating fans. Imagine you are in the bus. The bus made a right turn, and your body will be leaning towards left. So you are experiencing the centrifugal force, and that's the force the loop jump uses during the takeoff, with much higher speed of course. And now imagine the bus stops suddenly. Your body will lean forward. That's when you are experiencing the inertia of motion, and that's the force used by the flip jump during takeoff. The axel jump is completely different from all other five-figure skating jumps. It is the only jump that takes off forward and lands backward while rotating, giving it an extra half rotation. The takeoff relies solely on the leg and arm muscles of the skaters to propel them up in the air. An analogy for this, imagine the flight is taking off. The airplane starts the engine and speeds up on the runway. Only upon reaching a certain speed, the pilot pulls the elevator pitch up for takeoff. This is how axel jumps are performed. Except the engine is now their leg muscles. Remember, we had a video about how special triple axel is from Yuzuru Hanyu compared to other skaters? Using this analogy, you can understand it easier. The other skaters just need a longer runway to prepare for the takeoff, whereby Hanyu's body is a better engine and therefore requires a shorter runway to reach the speed required for takeoff of the triple axel. Okay. Back to the topic. For each of these three jumps, Hanyu would do the singles and the triples to compare the data. According to him, most data obtained worked well. There were some limitations in the tracking sensors, but the rotations in the air captured closely followed Hanyu's real body image. Then here comes the most interesting part in his thesis. From the perspective of a reader on his thesis, he sounded like Napoleon discovering the new world here. He realized there is a function in the output software called the contact points. In the video, you can see the red dot appears on the running foot touching the ground. This is a function that displays the part where the pressure is exerted on the ground. He did not pay much attention to this function until after he analyzed the data. You can see it can show clearly which side of the foot is touching the ground. During the jump takeoff, it clearly shows which side of the foot was used for the takeoff. Not only that, you can also know whether there is any pre-rotation of the jump by looking at the timing the red stays on the foot. For the skating fans out there, you would have noticed some videos focusing on exposing the wrong edge takeoff or pre-rotation of certain skaters not being called by the technical panels. This topic is also one of the most heated debates in the figure skating community. Let's take a look at the criticism done by the Italian commentators.
Si tratta del cinese Jimboyan, perfettamente eseguito.
Andiamo a vedere nel dettaglio lo stacco. Come vedete anche dalla grafica, il piede sinistro, lo sottolineava anche Massimiliano, su un filo esterno pulitissimo. Questo è il problema del cosiddetto wrong edge. Non esiste nel caso di Jimboyan, che esegue un loose da un filo esterno molto pulito. Attenzione alla puntata, piede destro. Vedete il piede destro sul ghiaccio? Appoggia sulla punta. Noi stiamo vedendo un rallenti, ma immaginate un contatto brevissimo, una frazione di secondo. Vedete come il pattino rimane in equilibrio sulla punta? Stacco perfetto e pre-rotazione ridotta al minimo. Andiamo esatto. A fare il confronto con un Lutz meno pulito tecnicamente.
Quindi memorizzate bene la puntata effettuata da Jimboyan. Qui siamo con il russo Dmitry Aliyev. L'elemento è lo stesso, quadruplo Lutz. Vedete il piede sinistro su un filo esterno, un filo chiaramente esterno, ma guardate che cosa succede col piede destro quando punta. Dopo la puntata
resta giù.
Sostanzialmente questo non è un lutz tecnicamente, ma è un Rydberger, perché è un salto che non viene preso dalla punta, ma dalla lama, dal filo. Dal
piede
filo
destro,
del piede destro.
Stiamo parlando della piede puntata destro. Del piede destro.
E poi guardate,
e guardate la prerotazione. Se torniamo leggermente indietro, andiamo a vedere ancora con la lente di ingrandimento proprio la puntata e lo stacco, vedrete che da qui, poco ancora prima, la puntata è frontale rispetto a noi, ecco, da qua, perfetto, vedete, il piede gira, andiamo avanti lentamente fino ad arrivare a darci praticamente le spalle. Vediamo il tacco, ecco, ha preso mezzo giro abbondante.
Ecco, sì, su sì, perché non guarda verso di lui. E metà giro in fase di stacco, quindi questo è un salto triplo.
Però poco più.
In questo momento passa come quadruplo, perché?
Tant'è che la combinazione quadruplo lus triplo toro di Jimboyan ha meritato 1,87, quella di Dimitri Aliyev, abbiamo appena visto, tecnica diversa, meno pulita, rotazione meno pulita, ha meritato 1,57.
So. Under the ISU judging criteria guidelines, poor takeoff and lack of rotations are all subjected to deductions in GOE. In Hanyu's thesis, he mentioned the limitation of human eyes. The technical panel can only see the jump from one direction and make a quick decision on whether to ratify the jump.
We have a general purpose learning algorithm that evolution has endowed us with, and it's running in an extremely slow computer. Very limited memory size, ability to send data to other computers. We have to use this funny mouth thing here.
Besides, there are some choreographers and coaches who will purposely place the jumps at the judge's blind spot to make it difficult to judge. As a result, more and more coaches started promoting these flawed and unsustainable techniques in the field. With this function, all these issues can be detected using reliable data. Besides, all the ambiguity in the scoring criteria such as good takeoff, good body position, and good speed can be properly defined using all the functions in the motion graphic data and by selecting a group of textbook jumpers for the definition initially. Finally, Hanyu concluded that the motion capture technology is useful for enabling the quantitative analysis of jumps in figure skating. It can be used not only for technical reformation, also for remote instruction of the coaches. To make it happen, it takes ISU to act on adopting the technology, just like how the International Gymnastic Federations work with Fujitsu to make the AI judging in gymnastics possible. Getting hype when I aim up. Elevating that game up. All right. That's it for our video today. Don't forget to leave a comment and let us know what do you think. Remember to subscribe and share it with your friends. Thank you. Stepping up to the competition. Only first place, and that's how I'm living.